format. Appending of data and updating of all formulas is automatically enabled when your data is converted into a table format. How to convert this data into a table format? Press Control A. Press Control A wherever you are inside the data. When you press Control A, the complete boundaries are selected. Complete boundaries are selected. What is the boundaries? 576 records plus 1, 577. First record is your title header. It is selected. Now you are going to convert this data into a tabular format. How you are going to convert? Press Control T. Control T represents table. Control T represents table format. Okay. You can see in the screen, create table. Where is the data for your table? You can see A1 to J577. This is the range of your data. So this range of your data, and you have an option there. My table has headers. Make sure that your table is having a header and that is checked in. Put a check mark or put a tick mark. I'm clicking OK. The moment I put OK, okay, you can see my table, my complete data is looking in a different format. This is called as a table format, banded rows. Okay, you can see banded rows here. Now, the moment your data is converted to table format, there is an option, an additional pop-up menu that is added to your menu bar called as design. This design, in the initial below the file, you can see the table name as table one. If you want, you can rename this table one. Otherwise, not an issue. In case you are having multiple databases in a single Excel file, it is better you give a unique name for each table for easy identification. Otherwise, you can leave it as such. Since we are going to deal with only one this kind of data, this is more than sufficient for us to proceed. Now, how to identify whether, see, I'm just renaming this data, for example. I'm just renaming this data and make sure that this table name should not have any spaces. Either you can use a underscore, otherwise it should not have any spaces, okay? Right. Now, how to identify whether there are data tables in your Excel sheet, Excel worksheet. Okay, there is something called as name manager in it. Name manager. How to activate a name manager? Press Control F3. F3, Control F3. You can see the data. You can see the data we have named here. Data and then the references here. Not for the see, this is a manipulated data. This is the data I created for this particular webinar purposes. So don't worry on the names and other things. This is a fake data that I created for this webinar. Okay. Now you can see the data is here. Some kind of additional data is also used here. Some kind of cross references. You leave it here, right? Now, this data, what is the purpose of converting this into a table? Now, you can see the moment you convert this data into a table, okay, what happens is like, 1 minute. You can see a menu that is popped up here, and you can see the lot of options here, table style options. Okay, what is the only numerical value that is available here? Sales is the only numerical value that is available here. Okay, now the moment you convert this data into a table, if you want to append this table, if you want to append this, add some more data to the table, when you keep the cursor in the last row and press tab. Keep the cursor in the last row and press tab, or otherwise copy and paste data below this, automatically the data gets appended. You can append the data and all the functionalities will be added to it. Okay. Now, next thing is like in the table tools, I'm clicking total row. The third row in Excel is like, you should not. The rule in Excel is like, you should not have a manual total. But when your data is cut. When when your data is converted into a tabular format, automatically what you can do is, like, you can see, you can enable this particular option. See, you can enable this particular option, and below the sales value, below the sales value, you can see there is an option here, drop down menu. When you click this drop down menu, you can see what are the options that are available for your table. You can sum the total sales for all the 3 years is sum. You need not use any formulas. Just like that, it gives you the answer and average. You can give an average and then count 576 records. Maximum sales 99864. What is the minimum sales? 0. And then count numbers. See, you have a lot of functionalities over here. This particular addition to your table will not have an impact on your analysis. This is an add-on to your table data. So that's it. So this is the first form that created. We have converted your data into a tabular format. Right now, next thing is, like, our real analysis starts now. We are going to create a pivot table for this data. We are going to create this pivot table now. You can see, click anywhere inside the table. Click anywhere inside the table. 1 minute. Yes. Click anywhere inside the table and then go to insert menu. Go to insert menu and click pivot table. Click anywhere inside the table. Go to insert menu and click pivot table. This is the one option of creating a pivot table. As I said earlier, you can also use shortcuts to create a pivot table. Alt, N and V. Alt, N and V. See, these shortcuts are available in abundance in the internet. You do not worry about the shortcuts and all. I'll also mail you the shortcuts. Okay. Alt and N and V will also create a dialog box for the pivot table. This dialog box consists of various options. See, table range is your data. Where you want to place your pivot table, whether in a new worksheet or existing worksheet. I have created several worksheets here. Create, summarize, show values as now. I have created several worksheets here. So what I am going to do is, like, I am going to place this pivot table in one single worksheet. In the worksheet that I have already created. Okay. So Alt N V in the existing worksheet. Click the existing worksheet and location. I'm clicking create and somewhere I'm placing, anywhere inside the worksheet, I'm placing this pivot table. Enter. You get the answer. You get the pivot table that is pasted in a new worksheet that is called as create. Now our real analysis starts. See, you have a sales data. Now let's prepare sales reports. How you are going to prepare sales reports? You will see it now. There are a lot of other tools that are available to create a pivot table, but Excel is a real master that gives you a lot of options to create a pivot table rather than without any coding. This complete session is zero formulas. I will not teach you any formulas, completely zero coding, and we'll be using other options in Excel to create a dashboard. Okay, now I'm going to see this. There are four quadrants here: rows, values, columns, and filters. These four quadrants represents the components of your pivot table. This is called as a pivot table field. This pivot table field is a menu that pops up when you're creating a pivot table. If you accidentally close this, for example, I have closed this, no issues. Just click anywhere inside the pivot table dialog, box here. The moment you create a pivot table, there will be two menu that pops up. One is analyze menu, another one is design menu. There are two menu that pops up. Go to the analyze menu and you can see at the last, show field list. There is an option that is called as a show field list. Click field list. Again, this pivot table fields will pop up. Now we are going to create a pivot table. Now listen, what is the beauty of pivot table? Now, very simple. Like, this pivot table will give you only the unique fields. I'll show you how it is possible. I'm just dragging products. This is a sales report I'm creating. I'm dragging products to rows. And you can see there are only four products. You have 576 records, sales records in your database, but it shows only four products: analog watch, antique watches, digital watch, and smart watch. So there are four products, and you can see sales of four products. The value column, rows and rows and columns will is the component of your pivot table. Value column, you can drag and drop the only value field that is available in your database, that is sales. I am dragging and dropping and sales in values. Now you can see the sales, total sales for all the 3 years. Some 2917 3815. This is the total sales for all the 3 years. This is the total sales for all the 3 years. Yes. Now I am adding one more thing. See, this is total sales for all the 3 years. What I want the report based on year. I'm just dragging and dropping year in columns. The moment you drag and drop year in columns, you can see the sales is segregated and then it is put up in the 2016, 17 and 18 with a grand total. And you want, you need some more clarification. Your boss is asking, no, I want to have a detailed description of each salesperson contribution in these products. Nothing, just drag salesperson and put it under products. And now you can see a simple sales report is generated here. This is analog watch. Under analog watch, there are four salesperson. The company has only four salesperson: Jagdish, Mohan Kumar, Roy Menon and Samiduri. These are the four people available and we have only four products also. So out of all these four, we have generated a sales report based on products. Your boss is again telling you, no, I want a different sales report. Based on salesperson, create a report. Very simple. Just you can look into the rows, move the salesperson above rows. Move the salesperson above rows, and for each salesperson, what is the product offerings, product sales, product targets that they have achieved. Everything is listed here. This is a simple sales report that you can generate out of your data. This is a very beauty of Excel that you can do. Further, what you can do is like, you can, there is an option here, filters. There is an option here that is called as a filters. Before that, you can see there is an empty cell here. There is an empty cell in Roy Menon analog watch. What you can do with this empty cell now, very simple, like wherever your pivot table shows empty, that represents Roy Menon has not sold any analog watch in the year 2017. That is the interpretation. Roy Menon has not sold any analog watch in the year 2017. That is the interpretation. Now what you can do is like, instead of showing empty, we can alter this data. How we can alter this data? Now you see, you can do any cosmetic changes to your pivot table that will not have an impact on your database. The source data will not have this impact. Source data remains as such, but you can do any cosmetic changes to your pivot table. Now listen, see, the Roy Menon is showing empty. Instead of that, when you go to analyze menu, click inside the pivot table, go to analyze menu, and there's a option below pivot table name. Here also you can rename the pivot table, and there is something called as pivot table options. I'm clicking options here. When the moment you click options, your dialog box opens. Okay. Submenus. These are the here. I am typing zero. So I'm just typing zero. I'm clicking OK. The moment you click OK, what happens is like, wherever the pivot table shows empty box, there you can see zero. It is updated with zero. It is anyway, instead of showing an empty cell, you can show it as a empty. You can show it as zero. Okay. Now, one more thing, one more last calculation, last thing addition to the pivot table. You can see there is something called as a filters here. There is something called as filters here. I am dragging and dropping channel partners who are called as channel partners in your, the people who distribute your product or some kind of people in your logistics, channel partners here. I'm putting the channel partners here. What is the use of filter now? Very simple, like you go to the channel partners, you have a button here, a drop down menu. When you click the drop down menu, you can see all the channel partners are listed here. Almost 100 plus channel partners are listed here, and check, I am checking select multiple items so that all the channel partners are checked. I am clicking all, unchecking all. I am going to select only a few people, 420 communications. There is a channel partner who is named as 420 communications. I am clicking OK. And now look at the data. Your data is changed according to the 420 communications. This is the way in which you can filter your data, cross filtering, instead of using formulas, VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, or if index match, find anything. You can just use pivot tables to filter your data from your database. Okay, I'm making it normal once again. I'm checking all, I'm clicking it OK now. So we have created a report. Now, the best part is visualization. You have a data. Now you need to visualize your data. Before visualization, I am removing this grand total. How you can remove this grand total? Now, very simple. Right click on the grand total and right click on the heading grand total and remove grand total. I don't want this grand total. You can see the odd figures here. Jagdish, there is a figure here. 2497060, 2430, all in bold form. This is nothing but your subtotal that. Now, 1 minute. This is nothing but a subtotal that is shown above your data. You can alter this also. Go to design menu, go to subtotals, show all subtotals at bottom of the group. There is an option, analyze and design menu. You have two things. Go to design menu, subtotals, show all subtotals at bottom of the group. The moment you do this, your data looks more clean. This is a simple sales report that you have created. See, what a sales report without a visualization, without a chart. Without a chart, no one will accept, right? So we will create a chart. There are two ways in which you can represent a data. One, creating a normal chart. Second, creating a in-cell chart. I'll show you how to create a normal chart. See, to create a normal chart, the very simple thing is like, anywhere click inside your data and press F11. Anywhere click inside your data and press F11. F11 is the function key. Automatically, that takes you to a new sheet with a chart of the pivot table. F11, that takes you to a new sheet, the chart of the pivot table. This is nowhere required. See, you cannot compare this particular data with the pivot table reports. So this is not required now. So I am deleting this. This is a very conventional way of creating a chart. There is a new way of creating a chart, which is called as an in-cell chart. Like, you create a chart within the boundaries of the cell. Within the boundaries of the cell, you can see near 2018, there is a space. This is called as a cell. I'm going to create a single chart within this particular boundary. How I am going to do this? You watch it now. 1 minute. Someone is still. Very informative. Help to repeat the subtotals option. Yes. Thank you. See, how to bring the subtotal here. See, very simple, like when you click inside the pivot table and you have two menu options here, analyze and design menu. And in the design menu, the first one is your subtotal. Subtotal here, so I have removed it. And then to have a better understanding, see, we are inclined to think that always subtotals will remain at the bottom of every group. So that's why I have put the subtotal at the bottom of the group, right? Now, I guess this answers your question. Mr. Arun Kumar, I suppose. Yes, he has asked this question. Can you able to hear me? Someone is telling unable to hear. Is your voice audible? Someone please answer.
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Audible, sir.
Right, sir. Thank you. Please mute all. Right. Now, we are going to create an in-cell chart. We are going to create a chart within a cell. within the boundaries of the cell, right? How to create this chart within a cell? You will see it now. See, go to insert menu. Insert menu, you have something called as sparkline graphics. Sparklines, we call it as a sparkline graphics, and this normally is sparklines. It consists of three options: line chart, column chart, and win or loss chart. I'm going to create only a single line chart. Just clicking, I'm keeping the cursor near the data. I'm clicking line. The moment I click line, there's a dialog box that opens. Create sparklines. Create sparklines. It asks you for a data range. I'm clicking this data range. You can click this button. Automatically, it asks you for a data range. I am selecting 2016, 17, and 18. That is analog watch of 2016, 17, and 18. Press enter and enter, double enter. The moment I press enter, you can see there's a